talk about honky tonk music. Excuse me, I just vomited a little in my mouth. The term honky, as a term for whites, comes from the two words bohunk and hunky. These words are used to describe somebody from East Central European descent. In the early 1900s, these were derogatory terms for Bohemians, Slovaks, Ukrainians, Hungarians, and Poles, Polaks, people from Poland. That's just not very nice. In Chicago, black workers at meatpacking factories overheard the East Central Europeans calling each other this. They grabbed onto this word and started using it in reference to all Caucasians. The tonk portion of honky tonk comes from a piano manufacturing firm. The firm's name was William Tonk and Brothers. They made large upright pianos, and they had a decal on their pianos that said Ernest A. Tonk. These upright pianos, manufactured in Chicago and New York, were called Tonk pianos. Some of them found their way to Tin Pan Alley and may have given way to the term honky-tonk bars. Tin Pan Alley was the street in New York City where all the artists would perform and practice and live and dwell. It was said that when you walk down this alley, it sounded like a bunch of people banging on tin pans or out-of-tune tonk pianos. Eventually, these honky-tonk bars made their way into the Deep South. And they were bars that served alcoholic beverages to the working class. The working class was their clientele, not the upper class, not the people who pay to have their cotton picked, those picking the cotton. The earliest mention of honky-tonk bars refers to them as variety theaters, where they would hold variety shows. These theaters often had a gambling house, always had a bar, and sometimes a brothel, just in case you need to get a little tail after losing in your gambling game. If the price is right, if you had enough left over. If you were smart, you would have put that money in your back pocket before you started gambling. The first music genre commonly known as honky-tonk was a form of piano playing related to ragtime, but emphasized rhythm more than harmony or melody. The style evolved in places where these pianos were poorly cared for, and they tended to be out of tune and had keys that would not function, keys that did not work, piano keys, that is. Honky-tonk was an important influence on what we now call boogie-woogie piano style. Anybody who knows Jim Croce knows the boogie-woogie piano style. Excuse me, I just vomited a little in my mouth. During the pre-World War II years, the music industry began calling honky-tonk music from Oklahoma and Texas west. Maybe west is... From where I'm sitting, west... as hillbilly music. Hillbilly like hee-haw. I'm from Kern County. I can't diss Buck Owens. In the mid to late 1950s, rockabilly, which was honky-tonk music mixed with rhythm and blues, rockabilly and the slick country music of Nashville put an end to honky-tonk's dominance. However, in the 1970s, it was revived. Outlaw's country brand of rough honky-tonk came to the stage. It was represented by artists such as Waylon Jennings, Willie Nelson, David Allen Coe, and Billy Joe Shaver. During the 1980s, a revival of slicker honky-tonk music came to the charts, beginning with Dwight Yoakam and George Strait. This more pop-orientated version of honky-tonk crossed over into the mainstream in the early 1990s, with singers such as Garth Brooks, Alan Jackson, and Clint Black. If I gotta hear any more honky-tonk music, I swear, I'm going to... Luckily I was able to swallow that one. I think those black factory workers in Chicago had every right to do what they did. They can't hate on me. I was one of them. My grandparents, my great-grandparents, we were one of them. We were working in the meat factories, getting 7 cents an hour or whatever the ridiculous wage was. Maybe it's only 2 cents an hour. I don't know. It was slave labor. My relatives were from Poland. I like to say we're from South Poland because that's where the mountains are. My last name means men from the mountains. So basically, we were cotton picking Polacks. I understand why they hate honky tonk music for the same reason I hate honky tonk music. Call